head of parallel and complementary intersection. See, this is the header or geyser. So we have to switch on the geyser. Then hot water will come from through the geyser in this direction. So here hot water will come and it will go like this. So hot water will enter here and hot water will leaves here. So there are two temperature sensors. See, one is at the exit of hot water and one is at the inlet of hot water. So this temperature is the inlet temperature of hot water and this is the exit temperature of hot water and this is the valve. Now it is closed. So when we open the valve, then the hot water that is coming from the geyser will exit through this pipe. So this is the regulating pump to discharge the hot water through the heat exchanger. Now see, this is the pipe. Here hot water is coming to here and there are two valves. One is here and one is here. Now I told you in the green board that in order to get parallel flow heat exchanger and counter flow heat exchanger, there is one constant, that is the direction of hot fluid flow is constant. So we have to vary the direction of cold fluid. If the direction of cold fluid is same, is parallel or in the same direction of the hot fluid flow, then it is called counter flow heat exchanger. And if the direction of cold fluid flow is in opposite to the direction of hot fluid flow, it will become a counter flow heat exchanger. Now we have to see the setup for parallel flow heat exchanger. Then afterwards we will see the setup for counter flow heat exchanger. Okay, see, so hot cold water is coming through this pipe to here, and if we have to close this one in order to get a parallel flow heat exchanger. See, when this valve is closed, that means cold water will not go through this valve. So cold water will flow through this pipe. Cold water will flow through this pipe. Now we have to open this valve and we have to close this valve. So when we open this valve, cold water will flow in this direction. Hot water is coming in this direction. It is flowing from right to left. Similarly, cold water is also flow from right to left. And the direction is same. Hot water is flowing in this direction, cold water is flowing in this direction. So it becomes a parallel flow heat exchanger. So see, cold water is flowing in this direction here. And cold water, when you open this valve, cold water will exit to this pipe. So for counter flow heat exchanger, this is the cold water inlet temperature. Here there is a temperature sensor and it is attached here. So it will record the cold water inlet temperature and see. This is another temperature sensor which is connected at the exit of cold water. So it will record the cold water exit temperature. And this is the parallel flow arrangement. So if you want to make a parallel flow heat exchanger, what we have to do? We have to first close the valve. We have to first close the valve. Similarly, this valve we have to close. Then we have to open this valve. When you open this valve, cold water that is coming through the pipe will flow in this direction. See, cold water will flow in this direction, it will flow in this direction, and it will flow in this direction, cold water. Hot water is coming in this direction, cold water is going in this direction. See, hot water is coming from right to left, cold water is going from left to right. So the direction is like this. So now it becomes a counter flow heat exchanger. And see, cold water is coming through this side, it is coming in this direction, now it is going in this direction. Now here, this valve is closed and we have to open this valve. So when we open this valve, cold water will exit through this pipe. So again, there are two temperature sensors. Now this temperature, previously it was recording the exit temperature of cold water. Now it will record the inlet temperature of cold water. As we have changed the direction of cold fluid flow. Similarly, this temperature sensor, previously in parallel flow heat exchanger, it was measuring the inlet temperature of cold water. Now in counter flow heat exchanger, as we have changed the direction of cold water fluid flow, so it will record the temperature of the cold water exit temperature. Now see, we have to switch on the power first. Okay. We have to check whether water is flowing or not. Just see by opening the hot water flow. We have to check whether water is flowing or not. Just for confirmation, I'm opening this one. Now see. See. This is the measuring flux. By using this measuring flux, we will calculate the mass flow rate of both cold fluid and mass flow rate hot fluid. See that water is flowing. Okay. Now what we have to do? We have to power on the heater. We have to supply current to the heater, and we have to wait some 10 to 15 minutes. After that, we will take the reading. And this is the regulator. Okay. See here. Now it is pointed towards 1. So if I regulate in clockwise direction, it will point towards 2, then 3, then 4. That means it will record the temperatures of all the 4 sensors. Means what are the temperatures sensed by these 4 temperature sensors will be shown here. Okay.
Maybe.
Now see. So first of all, we have to consider a parallel fluid extender. Then after considering the parallel fluid extender, we have to note down these 4 temperatures: THI, THE, TCA, TAC. Then after that, we will make our arrangement to counter fluid extender. See, as I told you, in parallel fluid extender, the direction of both hot fluid as well as the direction of cold fluid must be same. Means they are traveling in this direction. So hot fluid is traveling in this direction, cold fluid is traveling in this direction. See, hot fluid is coming through the region and it is traveling from right to left. It is traveling in this direction, hot fluid. Similarly, cold fluid, see, here this valve is closed. That means the fluid, cold fluid that is coming through this pipe is and going in this direction. This valve is open, so it is coming down and is going in this direction. That means hot fluid through the geyser is also flowing in this direction, and cold fluid is also flowing in this direction. That means hot fluid in right to left, cold fluid is also flowing from right to left. That's why this arrangement is called parallel flow arrangement, and this heat exchange is taking place between hot fluid and cold fluid. That's why it is called parallel flow heat exchanger. Now, here we have to record the temperatures. See, now this white mark. Now see, this white mark is pointed towards 1. So 1 means this temperature, means hot water inlet temperature. See, there is a temperature sensor and it records the temperature of hot water at the inlet to heat exchanger. So it is showing that 53 degrees centigrade. That means this TCI for parallel flow heat exchanger is 53 degree centigrade. 53 degree centigrade. Now we have to see THE. THE means this one. Hot fluid is coming through this direction and it's going through this valve. This valve is also open. So this temperature at the exit will sense the exit temperature of hot fluid, and by regulating to 0.2, we will get the exit temperature of hot fluid. It is around 45 degree centigrade. Now, parallel flow, that means cold fluid is entering in this direction from this side. So here one temperature sensor is here. So this measures the cold fluid inlet temperature, that is T3. See, it is 27 degree centigrade. That means cold fluid is entering the heat exchanger at 27 degree centigrade, and it is leaving here. It is leaving here, means it is going in this direction and it is leaving in this direction through this pipe. So here one temperature sensor is here, and this record the temperature of the exit temperature of cold fluid. So that is T4. T4 is 31 degree centigrade, 32 degree centigrade. That means see,
TH1, that is hot fluid inlet temperature 53, hot fluid leaving the heat exchanger at 45 degree centigrade, cold fluid entering the heat exchanger at 27 degree centigrade, then cold fluid leaving the heat exchanger at 32 degree centigrade. Now,
we have to make our arrangement for counter flow heat exchanger. So for counter flow heat exchanger, we have to close this valve and we have to open this valve. Okay. So I am closing this valve. Okay. This valve is closed. And I have to open this valve. Here I am opening this valve. So cold evaporator is flowing in this direction. Okay. And I have to open this one, this exit one of cold water. Okay. Required temperatures.